job he hates, a mortgage he can't afford. He loves his family and his children. He is empty inside. He goes through his day with less emotion than a rock that sits in the front yard. Actually, the rock has too much emotion. He is more like a fence post. There, that's more like it. He has the same breakfast every day. A piece of toast, no butter, two eggs over easy, a preformed hash brown, two pieces of turkey bacon, and an unusually small glass of orange juice. He eats them in almost the same order. Except he saves the toast for last as he finishes his unusually small glass of orange juice. This morning, Rick stops by to visit his family doctor. His nurse tells him he's depressed with voluntary fits of uncontrolled and suppressed rage.
It seems you're experiencing clinical depression with voluntary fits of uncontrolled suppressed rage.
As he sits there thinking on what the nurse just told him, his thoughts drift. He pictures the nurse. He wonders if under her pink uniform she's wearing white or purple panties. He thinks they should be purple. Little did he know, she was in fact wearing purple panties.
Learn how to drive! Son of a bitch! Fucking bullshit! Pull over! You fucking pull over!
Works on the second floor of a nice office building where the view is very good, but his office is in the middle and in fact has no window for enjoying this view. He turns on the computer, sits at his desk, and follows the same routine. He sits there doing his work, and as the mundane day progresses, unwilling to face his anger that is starting to build, Rick goes to the supply room to get a box of pencils. The supply room is not actually a supply room, but is in fact a kitchen converted into a supply room. Scott normally makes him smile. He opens the box of pencils on the desk and begins to break them one by one. Breaking the pencils did not have the satisfaction that he was expecting. Another box of pencils will subdue his rage. Breaking an entire another box of pencils does not have the satisfaction that he was expecting either. He needs to think bigger. Having broken all the pencils in the office, he has to resort to a box of pens. The pens prove to be more difficult to break than he was expecting, and all he can do is bite and pull them apart and pile them with the pencils. This angers him further, but has a touch of satisfaction. Rick has decided he can no longer take the mundane day and decides to leave for home. He stops for a moment on his way out and looks at the secretary. He thinks to himself, she is way too young to be a secretary. What he doesn't know is that she is in fact 23 and has a college degree.
I know I look too young to be a secretary, but I'm in fact 23 and have a college degree.
He finds himself at home again, staring at his own reflection in the very mirror that seems to be staring back at him with the same blank stare. The time has come for Rick. He can no longer deal with the unchanging mundane existence. He has his gun loaded. He is sure it is time, and he is convinced that once he's dead, no one will miss him. As Rick stands there, with the gun in his mouth, contemplating the inevitable, he thinks of the things that have led him to this point. His beautiful wife and children, the nurse with the purple panties, the secretary that looks way too young to be a secretary, but is in fact 23, the beautiful view from the office where he works, but not from the windowless area in which he sits. All of these thoughts run through his mind, and he realizes that he loves who he is. He loves his family. He loves his job. He loves the nurse with the purple panties. He even loves the secretary that looks too young to be a secretary, but is in fact 23 with a college degree. He doesn't even mind that his office has no view. Rick realizes that he is in fact happy. He sets down the gun.
It was just another day, like every day before. She had a plan away, kept it locked behind closed doors.